Hello everyone, welcome back to Chen Da DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to create a cinnamon roll bottle holder. And I have like a crop bottle holder. It's for another type of the bottle that have a shape small at the bottom and wider at the top part, as you can see in this video. But you also still can make different face of animal with the straight bottle. It's just the different of the body part. For this bottle holder, it is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And I also show you how to make the bottle holder bigger. Okay, now let's get into the video. For making this bottle holder, I used 2 strands of yarn and crochet it together. And I'm crochet it with 4.5mm hook. First thing first, make a magic ring or magic circle. And next, we are going to make single crochet stitch. For round 1, make single crochet into the circle. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the circle, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Keep making single crochet into the circle until you got 6 stitches. Then I will meet you back again. And after you got 6 stitches of single crochet, then pull the short string tight to close the circle. And next, we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. And this is what the first round looks like. Next, for round 2, chain 1. For chain 1, we don't count as a stitch. And then we are going to make increase into the same loop where we made slip stitch by make 2 single crochet into the same loop. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. It is where we are going to make slip stitch at the end of the row. After you got 2 stitches in the same loop, then keep repeating this into every stitch around by make 2 single crochet into the same loop. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, for this round 2, you must have 12 stitches in total. Then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the stitch that we mark. And next, for round 3, chain 1. Then make single crochet into the loop near chain 1. And don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. And next, make increase into the next stitch by make 2 single crochet into the same loop. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat this by make 1 single crochet. And then make increase into the next stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, you must end with increasing stitch, as you can see. And for this small loop near chain 1, we don't count it as a stitch. It's a slip stitch loop, so you just skip it, and we are going to continue with slip stitch into the stitch where we marked. And this is what round 3 looks like. Next, for round 4, chain 1, and make single crochet into the next 2 stitches. After you have made 2 single crochet, and then we are going to make increase into the next stitch. After you have made increase, then we are going to keep repeating this by make 2 single crochet, and then increase. Repeat around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, like I said, you must end with increasing stitch. Then we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch, which is where we use stitch marker to mark. This base it looks curved, so you just stretch it a little bit to give a nice and flat stitch. And next, for round 5, chain 1, then make 3 single crochet. And after you have made 3 single crochet, then make increase into the next stitch. And after you have made increase, then we are going to keep repeating this by make 3 single crochet, and then make increase. Repeat around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. And after you have made slip stitch, just stretch this base to give a nice and flat. You can try this on your bottle. It's okay if it's a little bit smaller than your bottle because it can stretch, and it's okay if it's a little bit bigger. For the measurement of this base, it is 3 inches length. To make this base more bigger, you can keep adding one more stitch into your previous row. Example, like my previous row, I make 3 single crochet and then increase. And for the next row, you have to add one more stitch, so it will be 4 single crochet and then make increase, 4 single crochet and then increase. And for the next row, you just make 5 single crochet and then increase, repeat around and then slip stitch at the end of the row. And next, we are going to continue make the body part around the border. So for round 1, we will keep the stitch into the back loop of the stitch only. Round 1, make single crochet back loop only into this stitch that where we made slip stitch. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. It is easy to know where the end of the row is. Keep making single crochet back loop only into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, like I said, for this small loop that we made slip stitch, we don't count it as a stitch, so you have to skip it. And for this base, if it looks curved, you can stretch it a little bit. And next, for round 2, we are going to continue make single crochet into this stitch that we mark. Remove the stitch marker and make single crochet into it. After you have made a single crochet, don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first stitch. It is the first stitch of your round 2. Then continue make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the stitch near stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row, which is the stitch near stitch marker. So for the next row, you just continue make single crochet into every stitch around and don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at the first single crochet stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach row 30, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you have made single crochet around until you reach row 30. If you guys want it more longer, you just add more rows. And if you want it shorter, you can make less row. And this is what it looks like when I tried on my bottle. And next, we are going to make the strap for the bottle holder. And after you got your desired length of your bottle holder, and next, we are going to make slip stitch into the stitch where we mark. And after you have made slip stitch, for row 1, chain 2. And after you have made 2 chains, then we are going to make the double crochet into the next stitch. To make the double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And next, for row 2, chain 2. Turn your work. Then we are going to make the double crochet into the big space. After you have made the double crochet into the big space, for the next row, you just keep repeating row 2 by chain 2, turn your work, and make the double crochet into the big space until you reach row 28. Then I will meet you back again. And if you guys want your strap more longer, you just add more row by repeat row 2. And next, I'm gonna show you how to attach the strap into the other side. You just fold this into 2 pieces like so. For my strap, I use 2 stitches and count the number of the stitches to make sure that both sides are even until you reach the other corner. Then you have to leave 2 stitches. It's the same number like the other side that we used to make the strap. And don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at that stitch. So for these 2 stitches, it is where we are going to attach the strap. And as you can see, for this both side is even, so we want the strap placed at the middle of the border holder. And next, turn your strap wrong side out or inside out like this. Then insert the hook into the first stitch marker and pull the yarn through. Then chain 1 and make single crochet both sides together into the next stitch by insert the hook into both sides loop, yarn over and pull through both loop, then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn, and this is what it looks like on the right side. And after you have made the strap, and next, I'm gonna show you how to make a cinema rose ear. For crochet the ear, I use only 1 strand of yarn with smaller hook, a 3.5mm hook. To begin, for round 1, make a magic ring. Then make 6 single crochet into the circle. And after you got 6 single crochet, then pull the short string tight to close the circle. And next, for round 2, continue make increase into the first single crochet stitch. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. After you have made increase, then keep repeating this by making increase into every stitch around until you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then we meet you back again. And after you reach the stitch near stitch marker, you must have 12 stitches in total. Next, for round 3, continue make single crochet into the stitch where you mark. Remember, always use stitch marker to mark at the first single crochet stitch. Keep making single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the stitch near stitch marker. Then we meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, for round 4, remove the stitch marker and we are going to make increase into that stitch. After you have made increase, then make single crochet into the next 2 stitches. After you have made 2 single crochet, then we are going to keep repeating this by making increase and then make 2 single crochet. Repeat around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, for round 5, remove the stitch marker and continue my single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, for round 6, we are going to make the crease. Remove the stitch marker. To make the crease, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we make single crochet decrease. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this decreasing stitch. Then continue make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. And after you have made 4 single crochet, then we are going to keep repeating this by make decrease. And then make 4 single crochet, repeat this around until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Remember, for this round 6, you must have 3 decreasing stitches. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, for round 7, continue making single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach round 7. And next, for round 8, we are going to make decrease, remove the stitch marker and make single crochet decrease. After you have made decrease, and then make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. And after you have made 4 single crochet, then keep repeating this by make decrease and then make 4 single crochet. Repeat this around until the end of the row. Remember, for this round 8, you must have 2 decreasing stitches. After you reach the end of the row, next, for round 9 and round 10, make single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you got 2 rounds of the single crochet stitch, no decrease, next, for round 11, remove the stitch marker and we are going to make decrease again. After you have made the crease, then make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. Keep repeating this around by make the crease and then make 4 single crochet. Remember, for round 11, you must have 2 decreasing stitches. Thank you. after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. And next, for round 12 and round 13, make single crochet into every stitch around. And after you have made 2 rounds of the single crochet stitch, next, for round 14, we are going to make the crease again. After you have made a decreasing stitch, then continue make single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row. For round 14, you only make 1 decreasing stitch. After you reach the end of the row, for round 15, make single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, then continue make slip stitch into the stitch that you mark. Then leave a long tail of yarn and cut it off. Don't forget to repeat the same thing to the other ear. And next, count 3 stitches away from the strap, and then we are going to sewing the ear into the bottle. So this is just a sample to show you. Next, I'm gonna show you how to sew the eye. For sewing the eye, we use 2 strands of yarn. And next, I'm gonna show you how to sew in the pink blush. We use 2 strands of yarn again. For sewing the mouth, we use only one strand of yarn. Now we are done for Cinnamoro for the holder. If you guys want to make the other animal, after you have made the body part and the strap, and then you can go to my previous video, or I will put the link down below. I have the tutorial that showing you how to make different animals like bear, duck, cat, or frog. Thank you so much for watching, and if you guys like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Subscribe to my channel and don't forget to follow me on my social medias, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.